Hello, this is Mona Toad for Pretty Pink Posh. In this video, I will show you how to create fun little summer scenes with cute images. In the main focus will be this adorable summer fun stamp set, which has so many cute images, and I will show you how easy it is to mix it with other sets as well. I stamped the picked images with alcohol marker friendly black ink to Nina Solar White cardstock with the help of my Misty. You can find the list of used stamps in the description box below. Before the coloring, I am giving a heat set to the stamped images to prevent ink smearing. For the coloring, I am using alcohol-based Spectrum Noir illustrators, but you can use any mediums you have. Just make sure to choose the right cardstock and ink. For the leaves, I have used mostly yellow-toned greens, where my darkest color was a mid-toned emerald green color. For these cute tigers, I have used reddish brown colors. With my darkest shade, I have created the shadows and I went slowly to brighter orange colors to have that perfect tiger look. To the mouth, I have used light beige colors to have that contrast. For the lions, I did the same process from the darkest to the lightest, but with warm browns with golden touch. The next step was to color the signs. I decided to make them onto wooden signs, which will be good props to a beach scene. For the coconuts, I have used the same colors as well. Because I wanted darker wooden signs, I have used darker colors, but it would be great with wood wash colors as well. For the flamingos, first I have used light pink color for creating the shadows. Then I added peachy coral petal colors for a nice twist. I just love how these two colors work perfectly together. For the hippo, I have used warm gray colors, and again, I started to build up the colors from the darkest to the lightest. I repeat the same process once more to have bigger contrast on this image and continue the coloring with the other small images and the hedgie as well. In case you want to see how to color a hedgehog, check my previous coloring tutorial. When the coloring was done, I ran the images through my die-cut machine with their coordinating dies and followed the die-cutting process with scalloped frames. Because these cards will be mini cards, I have used a smaller die. I also made some waves from Light Teal cardstock with the new Stitched Waves die set, and I have also made a stitched border for the sand from Nina Solar White cardstock. Now it's time for an ink blending. First, I am doing it with Broken China Distress Oxide ink. Then I continue to work on the sand, but this time with Antique Linen and Vintage Photo Distress Oxide inks. The next step was water splattering and to let them dry. Before I put my cards together, I stamped and heat embossed the sentiments with white embossing powder to the negative leftovers from previously die-cut frames. The used stamps are linked in the video description. In the end, I styled my cards and put them together with adhesive. Thank you so much for joining me today. See you next time. Bye.